In this video, I will show you how to make pencil drawings with After Effects. When you draw a line on the scene, you will see that it has been drawn by a pencil, and we will do this tutorial on a logo. I will show this with examples. You can also think of it as a text. You can think of it as a logo or any line you draw. You will understand better what I mean in a little while. First of all, I will create a composition in 1920 by 1080 size. Let's write pencil for the composition name to make it more organized, and let's make the background white for now. This will be a 10-second composition. Now, I'm going to add a logo to the scene to show this pencil effect. Let me show you this example as a start. I imported the logo. I click the OK button to bring the logo here. Then, I drag this logo into the workspace. This is a vector logo, that is, a logo in Illustrator format. Now, after adding this logo to our scene, I right-click on the logo, over the logo layer, and select the pre-compose option. We will see a screen like this. Let's call it logo again. And then, I choose the second option and click the OK button. The purpose of pre-compose is that we are going to put the effects that we are going to create right on this composition. Later, if you wish, we can go into the details of this composition and make changes on the composition. Come back again and make these effects and changes that we automatically give appear in our work. In the Smart Object logic in Photoshop, we can think of the pre-compose option here. Now let's move on to the effects panel. If the effects panel is not visible to you, make sure the effects and presets option is selected under the window, so you will be able to search on this effect panel. The first effect we need to find is the Vegas effect, which will make the logo in the scene appear as a drawing. I'm typing the Vegas here and dragging the result over the logo. Then we will need to make various adjustments on the effect controls panel. If you don't see this panel, we can still access it from the bottom of the window. See, effect controls is selected here. You must also have this option selected so that you can access this panel. First, we will change the blend mode. I change this option from over to transparent. If the color option is currently yellow by default, we will change it to the pencil color. It will be a slightly lighter color. Again, I come to the effect controls panel. We will change the value of channel under the image controls option. It is currently showing as intensity. We need to change it to alpha. When we change it to alpha, we will start to see the outline of the logo in the scene, the logo we added to the scene. At the moment, of course, the line appears as a line. That is, its outlines appear segment by segment. In order to make these outlines appear as a single piece, we need to set the segment's value under segments to 1 instead of 32. When you give the value 1, those segments will disappear as you can see. It will look like a single line. Of course, this one line will not be enough for us, because some areas are a little more blurry. We will also change this, and we will set the midpoint and opacity values to 1 in the effect controls panel. We can make all 1. I'm doing this 1. I'm going to make this 1 as well. And I'm making the middle value 1 as well. This doesn't correspond to the exact value of 1. It will remain at 0.99. Again, under segments, there is length. We will use this length value when we give animation. Currently, a value of 1 means show all lines of the logo. If we set this to 0, the logo lines will disappear completely. When we make this animation from scratch, the logo will appear as if it is being drawn. Let's see this drawing effect, that is, the logo effect, as an animation. What did we say? We will give this animation on length, so I'm moving the timeline to the beginning. I click on the keyframe icon on the left of the length value. I move the timeline forward for the number of seconds we want this logo to appear. Of course, we can change that later. Then I set the length value as 1. Now let's rewind the timeline and click play. Let's see what the result is. As you can see, with only lines, I can say that it is a nice animation, even if we want to do this editing. But the contours we see now are absolutely flawless. When we draw with a pencil, we can't draw exactly straight. Therefore, we will provide this slope using the turbulence effect. Therefore, this time, we will search for the turbulent displaced effect in the effect search box in the effect panel. I'm dragging this effect over the logo again. We will replace the displacement option with the bulge option, and we can set the amount to 25, 35 or 40. I'm going to give the value 40 right now. And in order to reduce that slope a little more, we need to devalue size. We can get it down to 2. Now, when we play it, we will be able to see that it looks a little more beautiful and drawn with a charcoal pencil. If you want a thicker pencil drawing effect, that is, if you want the outlines to get a little thicker, we may need to increase the width value under the rendering option a little more. When I do this 5 instead of 2, you will see a slightly thicker pencil effect. So, if you want to get a little more pencil effect, we need to increase the size value a little more. Let's do 3 instead of 2. Look, this is what it's become. If we do 2.5, it might look a little nicer. You should change this according to your logo or pencil thickness. Now, when I play the scene from the beginning again, we will see that there is an effect like this. We can add a paper image to the back. For example, I'm importing a paper image I found on the internet here. Of course, I need to put this under the logo. I can also play around with the size values and shrink it down to a size that I think looks nicer. When I replay it like this, I play with the space key and it's like this. These keyframes give us a somewhat static animation. We can develop this a little bit more. On the keyboard, with the logo selected, I press the letter U with the logo layer selected. When I press the letter U, it shows me the keyframes in the scene. I choose these two keyframes, I right click, select Easy Ease under Keyframe Assistant. We can achieve the same result by selecting two keyframes from the keyboard and pressing F9. Now, let's open the graph editor by clicking this icon. We should see something like this view. If you don't see such a view, you should right click on this area, an empty area, and select Edit Speed Graph. When you select this, we will encounter this screen. Now, I select the keyframe on the right, and a dot appears next to it. When I slide this point to the left, it will give us a view like this. This edit we made will change the dynamism on keyframes. It will make it look more effective and more beautiful. Now, when I play it again, we can see that there is a movement that looks much nicer. You can even use this feature in your animations alone. Of course, if the animation was fast, it is possible to slow down the animation a little more by moving the keyframe a little more to the right. As you can see, this is how we can give the pencil effect. By clicking on the graph editor icon again, we can switch back to the view we know. We can now turn off the effects in the effect controls panel, because we won't be making any changes to these effects again. If you remember at the beginning of the video, after adding a logo here, we created a new composition with pre-compose with the logo file. Now, we will use this practically of this. I double click on the logo layer and the logo itself appears. I'm going to write a text here now. I make this logo invisible. I get the text tool in the toolbox above and write my name here. Let me write my name in dark colors. Let's center this name both horizontally and vertically. I'm not doing anything else here on this page. I move on to our own composition, and when I play it from the beginning in this composition, look what kind of result we get. This is the basic logic of pre-compose. Changes we make within the pre-compose layer will automatically appear here and in this workspace. Now, let's put another logo here. I'll put the Twitter logo because Font Awesome is installed on my computer. I can quickly access these types of logos like fonts. If you are interested, I showed you how to install Font Awesome files on your computer in Photoshop. You can watch that video. I center this object again and come back to look at the results. When I play it, I can see that there is an animation like this. I really like the images drawn in this way. I want to try a few more examples from it. Let's try the PlayStation example. It doesn't take long to make these changes anyway, so it might be nice to look at different alternatives. I play the PlayStation icon again and it looks like this. Of course, we can use more than one logo here. I'm shrinking the exciting logo. I make a copy of it with Ctrl D. Let's take it this way, and this time use the Apple logo next to it, and here I come. Again, I can see the Apple logo and PlayStation logo moving in line. I am also wondering how these arrangements are made on the combined handwriting. I'll write directly Apple. Let's see how these things work with the cursive words on this logo. We will see it together. The effect of handwriting in which letters are connected can also have this effect. We have seen that too. Now, let's move on to our own logo again. That's it for this video. In this video, I showed you how lines can be created with a pencil effect. We can achieve the effect of pencil on paper with turbulent displace effect. You can use this effect in many different places according to your imagination. I hope it was useful. If you like this video, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.